hear everything, Scott?
I can hear everything.
Scott!
Cheers.
We are here. Shout out Bowerber. That's where we be. Check it out, y'all. Melbourne, Richmond.
Yeah, that's the place we're in right now.
They're looking after us until we get our studio. So, tool Dan.
Don't tell them where the fuck it is,
dude. Brunswick's a big fucking place. I'm giving the address.
I'm gonna lower the audio at that point.
This is Jungle Beats with a special guest in the building, Chris Palmer.
Woo!
Chris Palmer, we would not be here. I know I wouldn't be here without this man in front of me.
Thank you.
He really helped. I just needed to put this in. He really helped me get the position I got at the radio station that we were previously working at. Always indebted to him. He's done a lot for us to help us get to this position. So without this man, we probably wouldn't be here. So please put some respect on his name. Chris Palmer, you also make music, so plug that. I'll put that all up in the description. You talk about what you want to talk about.
Sure. I appreciate the love, man. It's always great. Yeah, it's cool. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm so bad. No, I'm all
check out Hudson. EP coming out soon. You're
Hudson Writes
now.
Raps. Yeah.
Hudson Writes Raps. That's your artist name.
That's the tag. Well, no, my name's Hudson, but like...
Your name's Chris.
The way you meant, yeah. Oh, you want to play a game? You want to play games with me? I'll walk out right now. You think of Drake's real name?
Aubrey.
You walk up to Drake and you go, Aubrey, what you doing?
Yeah, that's right.
Disrespect.
Man, you only say their name if you know the person.
So, well, he does know
me. I'm going to call him what his mama calls him.
He does know me, so that's fair enough. Yes. Like, you, yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, well, no, like the tag you can find me on socials is Hudson Raps Raps.
We're going to put it all in there.
You don't have the answer, Sway!
You don't have the answer, Sway!
That's Scott Hudson. We're going to talk about him very soon. All right, we're about to get to Drake More Life.
Yeah, yo.
Reaction review. It's been hard not to listen to this joint.
Yeah, right?
It's been hard not to listen to anything.
I'm surprised you haven't heard it yet.
Well, I listened to a couple of tracks just on playlists and Spotify and stuff like that. But like, I was like, nah, I'm coming on this. I'm doing this. I'm going to do as the boys do.
Right.
And like, not listen to it.
The internet's fucking buzzing on More Life. Yeah. This is a playlist on an album based on what Drake said. He wanted to be a seamless listen. He asked himself what would happen if he did an OVO Sound Radio, but every song was a Drake song. And he wanted people to say this was his next album, but he wanted to still keep the music flowing and keep people excited with this playlist.
I ain't saying nothing, but isn't like OVO Radio, like, isn't it every song a Drake song anyway? Like, it's always Feet Drake or something like that. Ain't nobody care about anything else, really.
Maybe, but this is what we got right now.
9 out of 10. Singles Chris. I haven't top 10.
9 out of 10.
On OVO Radio.
Ed Sheeran is...
You didn't tell me you were on radio.
That's only gonna make sense when the coupon comes out.
Yeah. Yeah, you're Lucio, I'm Pooty, you're gonna be.
What I like about you in this is that you're just like, I'm gonna wait till you finish.
I will wait till you finish.
You're some real motherfucker right here.
That's polite.
We gonna get into this bitch?
Yeah.
We're just gonna sit here, really.
Okay.
Shoot the breeze.
Alright, let's do this. Drake, More Life,
yeah.
Jungle Beats. Please support us on Patreon if you can. Otherwise, we still love you and we're still going to try and do this to the best of our abilities. Track one. I don't think they're ready.
I'm ready.
Free smoke.
Hiatus.
That's her name.
They're banned from Melbourne.
For real?
Yeah.
How you gonna start it? Oh! Free smoke!
Yeah! Mustn't never have your phone tap. All that yapping on the phone shit. You must really love the road life. All that never coming home shit. I brought the game to the knees. I made too much these days, never stay for me. Already know, yeah. I'm a troublemaker in the neighborhood. Boy, it's troublemaking goals, yeah. House party on the road, yeah.
That sounded like straight off the
Oh, this was in the trailer. This was in the trailer. Oh, bitch.
We out here. You done know, eh? It's an OVO thing, eh? You done know, eh? It's an east side thing, eh? You don't know, eh? More life!
I'm not a fan of Pop Can.
That's Pop Can?
That's Pop Can. He's on Gorilla's new album as well.
Are we gonna get to that?
Yo, that's a good way to start an album off, man.
Free smoke. Tell him who the vocals are in the start.
So the vocal are an artist called Napalm, and she's part of a group called Hiatus Coyote, which are a Melbourne-based neo-soul band.
Represent!
It's a song off their album, Choose Your Weapon, but I can't remember the name of the song. But it's a direct sample, which is quite cool.
Nice.
I'm not a huge fan of Hiatus Coyote, to be blunt, just to be transparent. But they are probably one of the biggest bands in like Melbourne, at least Melbourne. But they're like playing like major festival shows, and like they were at Falls Festival and Splendor in the Grass and stuff like that. They're big bands.
That's gotta be big for them to help their hair growth.
Definitely. It's going to be massive for them, man.
Yeah.
You could talk without having the mic. Go ahead.
Can you?
Yeah. I don't know. No, I mean, he can. Like, I don't want you to feel like you can't talk without having a mic in your hand.
He's trying to see if he can hear us.
Oh, you can talk.
Yo, I can talk and it's all fine.
Coming through that mic, yo.
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
You can hear me. From here, I can hear me from here.
Wow.
Yeah, that mic there is picking up the room.
What were you going to say?
That's better quality.
I was, the line that he has in that song where he's like, I fell asleep in sorority and like, I wouldn't do that now. Like, I don't know why it made me think of J. Cole. Like, I don't know why I thought that was like a J. Cole nod. Because I don't know, I feel like J. Cole said something similar. But
which,
I don't
know. Do you remember what track?
No, I think it's definitely from Forest Hills. But like, I just remember
was
like.
January, was it the first track?
Maybe. But like, but with this track, I like listened to that lyric and I was just like, I thought that was a J. Cole lyric. I don't know, man. Maybe I'm tripping.
I think that's a great way to start an album.
Yo.
Really solid.
You have my attention.
Is that 40 that produced that?
I don't have the answer.
I ain't got the answers.
You ain't got the answers, Flip!
I don't know, the way that beat came in, it was a very, if you're reading this, it's too late sort of beat. But his flow was definitely like...
I'm gonna tell you.
His flow was definitely like sort of Views mixed with some other shit.
He produced
like,
this shit.
Because he had like a sort of the same sort of like swagger, sameness as like the View sort of flow, but he switched up a bit more than he would have in there.
Alright, let's go.
Really cool, man. Next track?
Let's go. No Long Talk featuring Giggs, and No Giggs is from the UK.
Yeah.
Legendary Grime rapper.
Yeah, boy.
Drake's very close with him. So we about to get
it.
No Long Talk.
BBK.
Featuring Giggs.
Boy, better know.
That's Parker. He's a no long talker. Better like the motherfucking text slap. We don't need it hot, then I'm not nice. You try to date her and she better let me walk twice. Now you met her out of this tape.
What the hell was Giggs saying?
You don't know Tyler Man Giggs. Right now they say with the big man jersey, you get me more like flex. You don't know. I will be owing SM1 to the world.
That's just my ignorance. What was he saying?
Oh, I mean, like,
his own slang.
Yeah, it was just kind of like his own slang. Like, I think the biggest problem is that he was very much buried under the drums.
Right. His verse was weak compared to Drake's.
Yeah.
I thought it was weak. I thought that, like, the energy just dropped the fucking... Because he has a completely different energy than the way Drake
is. Yeah. It's definitely more laid back, but, like, under a Murder Beats beat, like, it was just kind of like... It just got drowned under the drums. Yeah. That song definitely lost traction when the feature kicked in.
Yeah, I didn't like the Giggs feature. No. He did good on the hook, but after that...
All right. Track 3. Now,
Passionfruit.
I heard some things about this song.
Yeah.
This key song's coming up.
Really? I don't know shit about it.
Song, this is the Christian one, yeah?
I don't know.
What? Christian?
Yeah, there's like the somewhere in an article that was like Drake's going back to his like Christian roots with this track.
Right.
Yeah, I'm super happy with doing that. Charles already did it. He's like, oh, I'm loyal Christian, whatever. Fucking over that shit.
Sorry if you're Christian.
The poster boy for atheism.
Yo, I'm agnostic.
I don't make decisions.
Track 3, Passionfruit.
Between us, just like we were fancies. You got issues that I mention, but
I like this.
Any violin, just come in with the violin. Oh, yeah.
Just a song that suits many different moods. We can plug this out in the background. We can plug this like a good song. Sucked a dick the other day.
So what was it?
That might pick you up, boy. You know.
I said I tripped my.
Fuck it.
Passionfruit.
Oh, that's a good song. I really like that.
I'm saying it. that one song was better than anything that was on Views.
Drop the mic.
Anything?
Anything.
Come on, man. That's first listen, though. We've got one listener.
That's not like if that's what Pop Drake wants to be, that's dope.
Yeah.
Like, no, why do you think that's dope compared to what you heard on Views?
Because Views was lazy. Okay. 100%. Views was like, I'm a take care, and I'm gonna put it through a top 40 filter, and I'm gonna try and get the best out. I'm gonna try and get the best out of me without having to put any work in there. And then it just didn't work.
And there's also the sort of the theory that we had about the leftovers from Views too, like, because if you're in Views, it's meant to be Views because of all the things that he cites. As
look at the hype singles for Views. It was 0 to 100, the catch up, Summer 16, like back to back. Okay, that's not meant to be a single, but like he was doing hype Drake, and suddenly he brings out this R&B record. Like, I mean, the record did really well. Like I have to acknowledge that. I absolutely have to acknowledge that. But like, nah, it wasn't good. It's his weakest record.
Okay.
Like.
I thought Thank You Later was weaker than Views.
That's a kid on his first go, though.
Exactly, but still, like, I think so.
You know, you can't come from Take Care, Nothing Was the Same, if you're reading This Is Too Late, and then put that out.
I don't know. But like, yeah, from a first listen, I could probably say over time, I can see that being like a better song than yeah. Views, but like, from Views, my favorite track on the album is Feel No Ways, because I love I love the sample on that, I love the hook, I love the verses. Feel No Ways, to me, is like the best song on the album.
Yeah. Hey,
thanks for hitting that love, baby. I see you hitting that love, baby.
I caused all the controversy. They're going to kill me.
Love her.
We're doing a More Life live reaction.
Yeah.
We on Instagram right now. If you're watching on right there, we on Instagram right now.
I got a new phone.
Hey, we're going to see that.
We're going to see.
Jungle Beats Media on Instagram. Anyway, the violins were fucking beautiful. Instrumentation.
Everything about that song.
You put violins on any song, you're going to get
pop,
me.
That's definitely the pop track I want to hear more.
All right.
Yeah, boy.
You got anything else you want to say on that?
Other than having a hard dick, no.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
That's beautiful. We gonna get is this beautiful. Is the Georgia interlude. I don't know if I'm saying that right.
Jorge.
Jorge?
Jorge?
I don't know.
J-O-R-J-A.
I don't know. I don't follow you guys on Instagram.
I'm going to say Georgia.
Oh, that's you sleeping. Don't sleep. Don't sleep.
I'm sleeping. Hold on. I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch
Sorry.
It.
That's not the
interlude. No, yeah, the interlude. And then we're
going to
get into
me.
Again to get
and
it
then
together.
Get it together it's featuring.
Inception. I'm watching y'all.
Featuring.
You're watching me while we watch
I'm watching y'all while I watch y'all.
Featuring Black Coffee. You can do that shit? Oh, bitch.
Oh, man, I'm looking at you.
Featuring Black Coffee and Jorah Smith.
Just let it light in the rose. Tell me I'm looking exhausted.
That was the laziest track so far.
I didn't like it.
Mm. I like the quick change.
I like the switch between beats. How I have
you
like the echo
need
effect,
to
like
get that shit together.
The club, then come back into the club.
Yeah.
But in terms of just the beat and that sort of style, like I do like how he's already implemented a few different styles through this album. Like you got the hype Drake,
yeah,
the pop Drake. That it's was the sort of new sort of clubby sort of dancehall Drake in a way. But like I didn't like that song very much.
That's definitely my least favorite so far.
It was pretty boring. I wouldn't replay it.
Didn't even feel like a Drake song. I felt like Black Coffee and the other feature were just holding that right there.
Yeah.
I think that's what it was. It was like their type of music. Georgia Drake Smith. Was like, I like this music, so I kind of want to do it.
I'm going to jump on it, yeah.
Exactly.
That's fine.
Hey, shout out to Drake trying new shit. Just don't do it again.
All right. Track 6.
Madiba Rhythm.
What he said.
Madiba Rhythm. Oh, yeah, that's a UK Grime speak right there.
I need distance between you and me. But I can teach me how to love.
Nope.
Yo. That was one of those tracks where to me it started off boring, but the more I listened to it, the more I got into it.
Nah.
You weren't feeling it?
Nah. Like, I couldn't even tell you anything about that song.
You could?
Like, literally, it had like a good marching drum beat, and that's about it.
Well, that's what was the problem with me at first. The drums were like. The drums still had that sort of like effect, like I'm still trying to go for that Jamaican bounce sort of
thing. Yeah, right, right.
And I don't fuck with that at all. So when he started up, I'm like, okay, I'm not going to dig this. But like, I feel like his lyrics drove it pretty well. There was, you know, the sort of like, it just sort of made me move a bit. Like I'd go back to it. I don't know if I like it, but it held my attention the whole way through.
It can make you move. It holds your attention. Yeah. It's a very simple.
Very
simple. This song is not made for like sophisticated hip hop listeners, I don't think. I think my girlfriend really liked this song. I feel like she just really fucked with it.
Yeah.
Right? Why do you laugh at that?
You would
like,
fuck with it.
I don't know. I just feel like it's like, no, this is a sophisticated hip hop listener. Oh. My girlfriend would like it though.
I set her up as like a non
sophisticated. Yeah, you kind of.
Oh, okay. I can see why I would laugh at that too then.
Yeah, I'd fuck to it.
I know there's love there, I know it's fine.
Yeah, it's but fine. For people who aren't that invested in hip hop, yeah, still love to jam to Drake, and still love to just dance and just have fun with a with a lighthearted beat and a lighthearted song that doesn't take itself too seriously.
It was better than the last track, that's all I know.
It's just very easy to listen to.
It's much of a muchness to me.
First three tracks, Flames, last
yes.
two.
Meh.
Hot, no, Warm Hot Dog Water.
Oh, fuck.
Track 7, Blem. You know what blem is? I know it's obviously like blem. Slang.
No.
We ain't no father for the islands, it gives you both no straight times. Cause you're crazy sometimes, and I only see you sometimes. Move from me when you're extra, move from me when...
I didn't mind that song. It started off kind of like with the auto-tune, whatever it was, I was like, nah, I ain't feeling it. But over time, like, I kind of dug what he was doing in that track. I didn't mind it.
Kind of still keep with that Caribbean kind of style and sound to it.
Yeah, see, I expect not to like it purely because of that, because I don't like that sort of stuff.
Right.
But once again, drew me in, I kind of liked it over more time.
It's very, like, it just sounds very formulaic. Like, this is just like the, I've heard this before. I've heard, yeah, I've heard this before. I can't remember the song. I've heard that many times.
Kevin Little's Turn Me On.
What?
Kevin Little's Turn Me On.
Is that what he said?
Let me drive you, come caress my body. You got me going crazy. From like 2003. Turn me on, drive you. Yeah. Or Ayaz's Replay. Anything by Sean Paul. It's not like
Sean Paul.
I don't get why he does this. It's almost like, well, Rihanna can do it, and it's just
right.
kind of like, but Rihanna's from Barbados. You're from Toronto. Like, you're not Jamaican. You're not Caribbean. You're not a dancehall artist. You can sample dancehall. You can bring dancehall artists in to do your thing. But, you know, when he's like, we go to the islands and we do the ting, like, it's just like, I don't believe you for a second. Like,
I mean, I'm a firm believer that you can be whoever you want to be despite your roots. As much as, you know, it's harder to do so.
But I think you're like, I think that's a whole, like, genre of music that's very specific to one area.
Yeah.
Well, actually, but that's, in what I've read, that's actually Toronto's lingo and dialect. Like, that's, a lot of that is actually, like, that ting shit, like, that's...
Ting's everywhere there, though.
Right, but that's also, like, Toronto's dialect. Correct? If anyone lives there, it's correct.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, if you do, you never know. And ting's used in, like, grime as
right.
well. Like, it's...
But that way he talks is, like...
But the Jamaican accent, like, do you know what I mean?
I can't say only Jamaican accent, but that dialect and lingo is, yeah, Toronto shit.
Cool.
Of course it
does.
Yeah,
Drake.
Drake.
666 million streams.
Is his seventh number one album?
It's a playlist.
But he only has 7 albums.
Yeah. But that's the, like, that's the other thing that I would raise is like if that's the case,
yes.
how come he didn't use it on any other record?
And now the hypothesis on that being, he didn't. What the fuck did it say here? If this is not my words, this is something I saw on copy here because I thought it was intriguing. If he decided to use it when he was up and coming, he would have limited his fan base only to Toronto mans, and that is a fan base that slowly transitioned to using a lot more Toronto lingo.
Interesting.
That's
interesting. Yeah.
Just a perspective.
Yeah, yeah.
That I found intriguing.
If it's yeah, if it turns out that that's a Toronto thing, then like you know, I'll eat my words 100%.
Right.
But like,
okay.
you know,
I want to see you with those words.
Eat those words, boy.
Put those words in a bowl. Eat
yeah.
A bowl.
No, I just I didn't fuck with
but
that.
I'm
track.
Glad you brought that out because that's a very legitimate thing that a lot of people have.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah, I mean, like it's with. Like appropriation is difficult. Like there's a huge divide between appropriation and like a tribute to something.
Right.
And like you got to just be careful about what you do and things like that. And I like but I do think it is good that he's doing it because he's bringing dancehall back into the mainstream. In like
everybody wants.
Dancehall's good.
That's all right.
But to me there's a difference between what he's doing by like emulating dancehall artists and what Kanye West did on Life of Pablo by having Sister Nancy the sample on
mm-hmm.
Famous.
Right.
Like that's very much bringing that dancehall vibe back into your song, but it very much being authentic from that.
Okay.
That
that's
kind of thing.
A good example.
But having said that again, if it's a Toronto thing then
it is.
It's authentic as fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair. 4422, probably an area code of some sort.
Must be how old he is.
Shit, well in this album cover he looks old.
Yo, Drake a vampire, Loki. Have you ever seen him in the sunlight before?
I'm gonna look this shit up.
4422.
He's a vampire?
4-4.
We got London on the track.
Ah! Stanford.
Say you change, but you never change.
Are you kidding?
No Drake.
Are you kidding?
Just Sampa.
What the fuck is that?
Oh,
no, hold on. I love that track.
It was beautiful. Sampa. Yeah.
Sampa's a fucking incredible talent. Right. No one sounds like him. Maybe James Blake, but they're on the. They're, he's the black James Blake.
Why, that was good.
Yeah, it was great. But why are you gonna put your name on the album? I don't care. You call it a playlist, and not even be on the track.
It's the same as Lemonade, though. Forward, James Blake. Beyonce's only backing vocals on that.
Mm-hmm.
It's entirely James Blake.
Fuck.
This is not a comparison by any stretch of the imagination. But on the EP that I'm working on, I've got an interlude where I'm not in it at all.
Okay.
Well, I feel like as long as the artist would know that like they're not on there, just because you're part of an experience, part of a playlist. So Sam probably knows that and appreciates what Drake's doing and is happy for the exposure.
Okay. Yeah. It's a playlist. I can accept it. I'm a little excited.
All right. So 44:22.
Yeah.
A lot of people have speculated that it's got to do with the Bible verse Isaiah 44:22, which the verse is, I have swept away your offenses like a cloud, your sins like the morning mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you.
Because the
song thematically deals with like redemption. And
exactly.
I'm sure that ties into Sampha's narrative as well.
That's a cool name for a track of it is to do with that, instead of just naming it the verse.
Yeah.
I actually like that.
Okay.
See if there's any samples or stuff like that. No. Nothing like that.
No, Sampha killed that shit.
Yeah, Sampha did kill that stuff.
I wonder. It makes stuff like this makes me wonder because like this just dropped and like Process has only been out for like how long?
Oh, probably 6 to 8 weeks.
6 to 8 weeks. I wonder if that was maybe like Drake visited him during like the process of making Process and was like, I like this. Can I? Like, maybe it was like an off cut that was like, oh, I'm not gonna put that on the record. No, because that's good. You should put it on my playlist. Like,
I reckon that would have fit on the album. Yeah. I can imagine it fitting into Process.
Do you know what I mean? Because like stuff gets cut off records all the time where you like even like it could perfectly fit the concept of the record. Well, you just don't want it on there.
Like J. Cole, he always puts shit in the vault for his next album. He plans shit all the time.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like the track that put out as Exchange with Bryce Tiller. He had that in the bank for Forest Hill Drive, but waited for the next album to put it out.
Yeah.
Same Wet Dreams. He had Wet Dreams when he put out
That's old Cold Drums. I read that.
Yeah, exactly. There's lots of artists keep shit in the vault.
Yeah.
But why is Drake gonna say he wanted to make a playlist that was just basically all him, Drake on every track, and he doesn't put himself on this track?
Well, let me look at the thing. So the track's called 44:22.
I mean, I like it regardless, and I like how he's trying to put on other artists. I definitely have respect for that. But
he didn't even write anything in it.
All right.
Like he has no involvement in this track at all. Other than it being on there.
Okay. Well, it's okay. All me. Fine.
Alright. Next one. Galchester.
Is that how you say it?
Galchester.
Galchester, thank you. I would have butchered that.
I would have said Gail Catestator.
Galchester.
Galchester. We're back.
Nice to meet. Sick. Tat on my wrist. I got it. I know. We're coming in. Got two and I got one. Thought you had one, but it's not one. Nigga,
okay.
Hermes Link. Ice blue me. Tell my
ribs,
like I do not know.
Yeah! I don't give a fuck what y'all
said. Offset!
That was boring.
That beat though.
You vibed. I watched you vibe.
I vibe because the beat's hot.
Yeah.
He didn't switch the flow up once and he wasn't saying much at all that was interesting.
No, he wasn't, but.
It sounded like a Migos track.
I'd dance that in the club.
Yeah.
Oh, I danced with it in the club, but like.
But that's what it is though. Do you know what I mean? That's all it is.
But then we go back the previous.
I liked it. I didn't expect a lot from it. Do you know what I mean?
If you take it for what it is, it's fine. I just expect more.
You want more?
I think with Drake, I get two things with Drake. I get like really like poppy kind of feel good stuff that's kind of like you can bop along to this. And then I get like the hardcore kind of emotional Drake, but not complicated emotional Drake. Like to me Kendrick is super emotionally complicated. Like things like hood politics, like going back to Compton after becoming famous and being like, I can't live here anymore. How much does the dollar cost? You know, the complexities of his existence. And I'm not saying that Drake's not a complicated person, but I'm just saying that the emotions that he tackles are a lot less complicated. They're kind of like, you know, like in like to draw on Sampha, like Too Much is one of my favorite Drake songs. Yeah. And like that line where he talks about his uncle saying, well, I guess that's life and I don't get to do the things I wanted to do. And he's like, no, you can still do what you want to do. You just got to get in that mindset. Like that's a really simple way of putting that, but it's really deep.
And that's simple.
And simplicity is hard to do.
Right.
So this is not a disrespect to Drake. Like this is like literally what he does is really hard to do.
But Drake makes it relatable.
Yes.
He makes so many facets of the masculine identity
as
a person relatable.
Yes.
And I think that's why he taps into so much of our culture.
For me, it's kind of like with Drake, it's kind of like he's like we're having a conversation with him where it's like, I feel this way and I feel this way. With Kendrick, I feel like I'm being talked at. I feel like he's talking to me, like he's kind of making a speech at me. He's like, we got to do this and we got to do this and we got to do this. And this is what we need to do. Whereas Drake's just kind of like, I'm not doing well. How are you doing? Do you know what I mean? I don't know if that's a really convoluted way of like describing that.
I think it's a little bit, but...
Yeah.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
That's a cop-out way of me saying...
I want to move on.
Yeah.
I didn't like it. Next track.
All right. Skepta interlude.
Yeah, I talked a lot for a song I didn't like.
All right, Skepta!
Release wish, I'm stuck in prison. Fish eye lens in my tunnel vision. Listen, but it's greatness only for the love of Britain. I say it out with instant, no fuck to give him.
Mercury Prize winning Skepta.
You hear me, Jim? I hate a goofy as Vegely.
That's a Skepta doing Skepta right there.
That's how you do a grime sample.
That's Drake on grime.
Hell.
But it wasn't purely grime. It wasn't that grime, actually.
It's grime on a trap beat.
Had elements. Yeah, exactly.
This is right. Interesting.
I thought it was good to hype up. I liked it better than last track. It was pretty much like a better hype track than before with a bit more diversity. Skepta did this thing, Drake did this thing, this is good.
I'm not too fond of... this is now the second, arguably third song that's pretty much predominantly not Drake.
Maybe that's what he's going for with this. He's trying to try new shit.
Sure.
Shit there's always been...
I did like when they did the call and it was like BBK OVO. Like, I think that'll be the new kind of... I reckon they'll merge.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. Here we go. Okay. This is Portland, and apparently I was featuring Quavo and Travis Scott. Now, apparently I was pronouncing Quavo wrong.
Quavo!
Quavo. My fault. You guys up there, my fault. It's Quavo. That tells you how much I know about the Migos. Not much. Quavo.
The Migos.
This is the
meme song.
The what?
This is the meme song. This is the one that everyone blew up on Twitter about.
Because
the flutes.
Up here.
Portland, yeah.
It's
the only
Quavo
one I've heard.
And Travis Scott.
Yeah, because there's flutes on this track that everyone's like, oh, damn, flutes though.
Did they bring the flutes this time?
They bring the flutes.
Maybe they talk to Jay-Z.
The
flutes.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
The flutes.
It's all BB's ting,
yeah.
It's all BB's ting, yeah. That's with the screen crack. Steer him back right away.
That's
flutes on. Don't come around, think again, say it.
Recorder Ooh. Lessons.
Yeah, that's why. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Hey, do you little Yoni's like, yo, I'm gonna come in and play my recorder.
Yeah. Let me play, guys.
That's all he's good for.
Hey. There's a lot to unpack in this song.
Yeah, the flutes, legendary.
The flutes,
the
legendary.
Flutes will go down.
You see, look at Jamal.
The flutes are always recorded.
Show ass on Twitter.
Travis Scott feature on fucking point.
I wanna shout out the particular line where he says, "No, I did not sign with Jay, but I still send a tidal wave."
Oh shit.
I didn't even cry in old shit.
I'm gonna shout that out.
That was an old shit.
Okay.
I like it. Skirt, skirt.
Yeah.
Skirt, skirt.
The laziest skirt. You need to pick up your skirt.
What
game.
About
the
like, skirt, skirt, skirt.
What do you guys think about? So, like, Quavo, the hook is
Quavo.
Hell nah. Never let these ride your wave.
Never let what?
Never let these. I ain't saying it, boy. You ain't know that shit. I don't know how y'all do things here, but a dropout, we don't say that shit.
Never let these men?
Never let these.
No, he's not comfortable saying that.
Men of a certain appearance.
He's not comfortable saying the N word either. reasons.
But hell nah, never let these ride your wave.
Yeah.
Right. So this was kind of like the first taste of More Life that we got.
Yeah.
And More Life has been plagued with accusations of taking on Cuddy.
Yeah.
Surfing, first single from his side. Yeah. Nah, I ain't riding no wave. Too busy making my own waves.
Yeah.
Right.
I ain't got no wave.
I agree with that. Kid Cudi was instrumental in helping Kanye craft his sound with 808s.
It's true.
That created a new wave, right? And yeah, that wave today has helped Drake and many other artists yeah, as a platform to do their thing.
Yeah.
I think Quavo helped create his own wave with Migos and with these guys.
Yeah.
And at the same time, he's used other people's waves to help himself create that.
Quavo's done the most out of the Migos.
So. Yeah. But my point is, like, is that like a lot of people online are saying this is a shot at Cardi.
Why would Quavo take a shot? People
jump in on beefs all the time, like if they're friends with staff.
I don't think it's a beef.
I don't have any evidence. It's just maybe coincidence.
Why not? I like that track. It bangs.
Screw, screw. Yeah, it's a good track.
I could have just done with.
I'm bringing up the controversy.
Could have just done with.
No, bring it, please. Yeah.
Didn't need Quavo, but you know he's there.
Screw, screw. Hell nah.
Hell yeah, that beat slaps so hard though.
You wanna get track 12?
Let's hit it, man.
Sacrifices featuring 2 Chainz, aka.
Oh,
2 Chainz!
Yo, I've heard someone told me that the best verse in this album is the Young verse we're about to hear. The Young Thug verse we're about to hear.
Yeah, boy.
My homie Josh Daniel said the Thugger verse is the best track yeah, on this great album.
Get the fuck out of here, Josh Daniels. Yo, I haven't heard the song yet, so.
I come for you!
I want to eat my words.
Let's go.
Say your own thing, so be careful what you think. Think about what you gon' say. You can trap my heels. Got a wood on the car today. Got some face full of splinters. Count a bank on my gun. This is the wrong place to end. Fuck the wrong, I had no choice in my defense. So I don't want you to know about us, so shackles us. Probably got a problem setting. I'm talking about it like a sign. My dad's
him.
That was a pretty good track. On the piano, I thought 2 Chainz verse, Drake verse.
Cohesive.
Thugs verse, they're all quite different, but they all molded pretty well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I actually loved it when Thug actually didn't have autotune and he switched up towards the mid
right,
verse.
Yeah.
Caught my attention.
Yeah. It's nice to hear him now.
Something a bit different, yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, it was dope. I dug that.
Was there something more to that song that kind of missed upon first listen, like lyrically? Was there more depth there than I didn't.
I think reading along with the lyrics, like, I didn't care for Thug's verse. I think like it didn't really say anything. Like. Drake.
It's his track.
The hook is great. The hook is like, I've made these sacrifices and it's like worked out. And like, it kind of make you wonder what he has to have to give up. And he's talked like, and then, I mean, for Drake, it's always usually it's like a romantic thing or like woman he's had to give up and things like that. And he's talked about like, you know, using, you know, his ex-girlfriend's voice messages in Marvin's room and then getting sued for it.
Oh, for real? That happened?
Yeah, that's real. Those voicemails where it's like, I don't know, I'm going to get a drink. Like, I don't know, you know? Yeah, she made so much money off him. Yeah.
Really?
So you know that was, are you drunk right now?
Right.
Like that's his real ex-girlfriend.
She sued him?
Yeah, she sued him because he did it without her consent.
Damn, well, I would have done that shit too. It worked. It made the song's beautiful.
Yeah, lost a lot of money.
How much?
It was, six
figures or 7 figures?
Probably 6 figures. Because it's a huge breach of privacy. I think it's also a federal case.
Jesus, all right.
But like, yeah. So like I liked it. I thought it was a good song.
Yeah,
I fucking liked it. Yeah, that and the last track have been great. It's probably about, I think so far half the album I've liked and half the album I've been quite bored by.
This is definitely a better strike rate than Views for me.
I've enjoyed Views more so far.
You agreed. Track 13, Nothing's Into Something.
I ain't gonna tell you you're wrong in your own house.
Views just seems more cohesive so far.
Just opinions, man. They're like assholes, you know. Everyone's got something.
This is my time. This is my kind of Drake. This is so far gone, sort of Drake.
Yeah.
Otherwise. This is like very old school beat.
Yeah. This is good.
Woo!
We just let it go.
Yeah.
This is so far gone.
Yeah.
That was a nostalgic as fuck track in terms of his first time. Like, So Far Gone was written all over that.
Right.
All over that. Fuck with it. Love it.
Alright.
Last 3 tracks I've really been digging.
Very minimalist type beat.
It's kind of how
it was enough. It was just enough.
Yeah,
I liked it. Okay.
It's like A-Man said. It's like a So Far Gone type shit.
We don't need to say much more on that.
No, it's dope.
This next one's the one though.
Is it?
The one?
This is the J-Lo cup.
The what?
The what?
The J-Lo cup.
What's that mean?
He samples J-Lo.
Okay. Ah. So.
That's the, yeah. That's the, everyone's hyped around it.
Because everyone thought everyone loves J-Lo. Were hooking up.
Well, he thought they were hooking up, but it turns out it was like they reckon he was now just trying to lock the sample in.
Ah, so Drake.
We'll see how it goes.
Hey, motherfucker.
Using it for the sample. Cha!
Your heart is hard to carry after dark times.
Last four tracks, amazing.
Yeah, that was
the way the album's flowing now is like, I feel like the album's always been flowing in terms of changing different styles of what he wants to do with music, but now it's more the style that I really like hearing him on.
Right. Mm. One of the best tracks so
far.
Oh yeah,
definitely. One of my favorites. I think Passionfruit's my favorite, but that's probably the second one now.
Do you think, this is just me,
do you think?
Vibing. Do you think he's like, it's almost like he's shouting out each one of his past projects?
From what we're hearing so far,
yeah.
I've definitely heard elements of Take Care. Nothing was the same. So far gone. I don't think I've heard sort of anything from...
If you're reading this. Oh no, look, like no, Free Smoke could have been like, yeah.
Definitely some bit of views in the flow from the track after that.
Yeah.
Definitely, Take Me Later was the one where you can't really pick it because there were so many different sounds on Take Me Later. It's just sort of like...
trying that stuff,
getting the production that like everyone came to him, so you can't really pick too much from that album. I think definitely his weakest one, but with the best, his best.
Interesting, story. nothing really from What a Time to Be Alive.
But I feel like that was more a Future album.
Yeah, it's fair.
I feel like he just was like, Future was like, "Hey, I want to do this album," and Drake was like, "Yeah, why the fuck not?" And he did it.
I got a spare 25 minutes. They recorded that in 4 days.
Yeah.
And how much money did they make?
A lot.
That's a good ratio.
Yeah.
Tell you that. Mm-hmm. Alright.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
That was really great.
Yeah.
At the moment,
great job, Drake.
I'm loving the Drake.
Great fucking job, man. You do like a whole album like that. You get fucking girls wet everywhere.
Fuck, man. My dick is leaking.
Yeah, got
leaking happy juice.
Nah, yeah. For real though. If he made an entire record of that style, it'd be his best record.
Shut it down.
Yeah.
Shut the fucking shit down. You get track 15.
Everybody else can go home.
Yeah. Hey?
Everybody else can go home.
Oh man. Except Kendrick. He can stay.
Yeah.
Glad we can share love on that one.
KMT featuring Giggs again.
Hey, I gave my girl the best.
Sounds like somebody.
Not even taking the chance. Studio right in my heart. I'm gonna turn it around. Making them curvy.
Really
gonna love them breasts. Making them perky.
Didn't like the feature. It killed the energy that Drake had already.
Agreed.
Created. I got enemies. Got a lot of enemies. Got
sure.
A lot of haters trying to.
Don't hear the synergy.
Trying to take away from her.
I feel like, I know Drake and him are good friends, but how does Drake tell his best friend that I don't fuck with that verse?
Well, he probably does fuck with his verse because Drake's a fan of his work. So Drake probably hear that and be like, fuck yeah, I fuck with that.
Why?
I'm like, why?
I'm curious.
Well, it's kind of like, for example, Diddy. No one really likes his music, but if you're a fan of Diddy, you get him on your project, you're probably going to like his verse, but no one else will fucking like it.
I don't know, when you dropped that album with the big glasses and the blue cover, what was that called?
Which one?
The Dirty Money one?
No.
Who's this? Diddy?
Fucking.
Who cares?
I can't remember because it's fucking water.
Anyway.
Probably called Ciroc.
50 Cent feature?
F 50 Cent will drop an album called Effin. Effin Vodka. Anyway.
How did you not get bankrupt featuring 50 Cent?
Yeah, first half was good with Drake, second half, snoozer.
Not great.
Oh, I didn't even like Drake on there, honestly. He didn't switch the flop at all.
No, it wasn't amazing.
The beat was, I wasn't a big fan.
Yeah.
Okay. Track 16, Lose You.
You never lose me.
I'm going dumb, please never label niggas who lay down for a living my competition. Be honest with myself and take ownership. Opinions started to burn when tables started to turn. I really used to feel like they loved the nigga at first. Did I lose you?
Woo!
Did I?
That's a fucking
did
track.
Did I lose you?
Put some bars on it too.
Yeah.
Did I?
There was some motherfucking bars on that.
I enjoyed that, yeah.
To me, like, more the highlights of this album for me have been more of the R&B tunes. That's the best rap tune we've heard so far. Because pretty much every rap song before this has been Hype Drake.
Yeah.
That was, once again, so far gone, spitting. You know what I told you before about the emotional Drake we like to hear?
Yeah.
That was everything just then.
Yeah.
That was everything just then.
100%. I wouldn't say so much so far gone. I definitely agree with you, though. But I would say it was also a bit of Nothing Was the Same though, with the production.
I feel like the
they complement each other.
Boom,
yeah.
Boom,
yeah.
That was a So Far Gone.
Yeah.
And then the everything backing that was the same.
Yeah, agreed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
all the elements, man.
Very astute observation.
I'm seeing
friend.
Like what he means now with like the playlist compared. It's like all of his work compiled into like playlist. Yeah, it sort of gives you life. Everything for track, but in the newer sense. It's just like it's all making sense to me.
It's almost like the cadence towards the latter half of the track. It's almost like he's not even rapping. He's just talking. Do I just get that? Is that just me?
No, I got
that.
It
just feels like he's like, but it still works, right?
Mm. Yeah.
You hear him. It's just very like
Drake?
Casual.
Yeah. I feel like when he's saying the most is when he sort of loses himself more. Because if he's focusing too much on his flow and being like that,
he's saying some
more
stuff.
On the style. This is more him focusing on the words.
Sometimes you hear him and you think for a second that he's offbeat and that he's out of flow.
Mm.
But sometimes he says the real shit when he's just there.
And that's an example of a song where there might be some stuff there.
So many different types of Drake, man.
If you gotta give me an album with that, like Lose You,
like on
Teenage Fever.
What's the track? What's the track on Nothing Was the Same? Where he's like, you know, if you end up needing some help, I can help you out. You know, back on your feet and shit.
I
don't know.
That's Tuscan Leather, isn't it?
Is it Tuscan Leather?
Oh fuck, Tuscan Leathers.
Yeah, but you know what I mean. But that always felt offbeat. But like, it fits
perfectly.
Yeah, great. Another great song.
Yeah.
Track 17, Can't Have Everything. Very very emotive titles, very like
that's Drizzy.
Yeah.
Let's get a man, come and get your man's first you caught their hands and you took a stand. It's a joke, but you say you all that drink and stand.
Seaside,
east side, all that for my area.
Very similar aggression emotion to Underground Kings. Very reminiscent of beats from Take Care. Like,
a good memory.
He did his fucking shit on that. I'm a big Drake fan, man.
For real?
Yeah, I love Drake. I've grown up with him since So Far Gone.
Oh man, I've never heard those words. You love Drake, I think, or like you're a big fan.
He ain't top 10, but like he's you know, I've grown with him all the way.
He's influential too.
Very influential
in the music culture.
He's had a big impact on hip hop as well in the past like 8 years. So.
All right, so. That was his mum at the end.
It was.
Yeah. And so the speculation also known as the genius annotation. Shout out genius.
Shout out.
I quite like genius. It's quite good. Sandy Graham, who is his mother, sends a voicemail to Drake saying she's concerned about Drake's negative tone on the diss tracks towards Meek Mill.
Oh, really?
Probably referring to his ruthless lyrics on Back to Back. Drake is dealing with so many trust issues, especially with women, as he says in Passionfruit, which is the one we read before.
Mm-hmm.
Sandy talks about how proud she is of Drake. And there's also the segue into the next song, which they're talking about, which has a favorite on there.
There you go.
Somebody featured.
I think with what I'm hearing, like, I'm liking individual tracks more on this album than
But
I didn't, there's probably only a few tracks I didn't like it. So with this album, there's tracks that I really don't like at all in terms of the him trying to get that Jamaican vibe.
Yeah.
Like all of that, if he took that off and kept like everything else going, I'd fucking love this album a whole lot. I can see why he's doing it.
Yeah, but I think like I mean, in his career, he's on like in my opinion, he's only really made two cohesive pieces of work, and that's Take Care and Nothing Was the Same, which really flow. Like no, it's not cohesive.
I feel like if that would be,
it's
that
got a vibe.
Could be in the equation, for some people.
Yeah, it could be.
Yeah,
but maybe not. Obviously, for you.
Yeah,
but
and I think maybe views for some people. Views might have.
Views is cohesive,
right?
It's just in terms of it's him not trying much too new, it's him not going out to his boundaries. He stays in the zone.
Yeah.
That's what you do when you don't agree with somebody but you know it can't be bothered.
I agree. I agree with you, like staying within his limits and kind of things like that. Yeah, I definitely agree.
Alright. I forgot what I was gonna say, but
sorry, man, I cut you off.
So good. So
Glow.
Glow. Featuring Kanye West.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a little excited.
This can't be chosen, but you know, Chipotle.
We've heard Kanye features before, and he says like one thing on it. It's like, fuck, that's a Kanye feature. Exactly. Or he puts
catfish.
Or he puts a drum on it, and people say that's a feature. So I hope we get a verse out of Kanye. All right.
Give us a real Friends verse. Give us some fucking bars.
They ain't ready for that, man.
It's called Glow. It's coming back. Yo, I put glitter on me. I walk into the strippers. I don't know.
Watch out for me. I'm about to glow. You broke up. Watch out for me.
Oh,
time to shake your glass. Time to change your life. No more 9 to 5. Autopilot drive. All summertime. Watch out.
to get the whole nine, the whole nine.
Yo.
For real. Oh.
That's the best one.
What? It's up there.
That's the best one.
It's up there. The way they interchange with each other.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm glad they did it that way.
The way they interchange, the Earth, Wind, and Fire sample at the end.
Oh. Did you know that they haven't collaborated since forever? Which Drake dropped
That's not
before.
True, because they did. Okay, maybe we're looking at it differently. Drake and him and Jay worked on Popstar.
That doesn't count. That was a throne.
Pop style?
That's a feature.
Kanye
had a verse on it.
Was a pop style.
Okay, but before then...
I mean, Kanye cares about it because he performed it at the Pablo tour.
Right, yeah. But before then, is that really forever?
Yeah.
Before
yeah.
They really not perform
yeah.
like, on an
they
album?
Never, they never do anything together.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. And you know what's interesting about that? Did any of you see his interview, Drake's interview... his last audio interview with someone in the UK, and he talked about
Zane Rowe.
Not Zane Lowe.
Okay.
Sorry,
Tim Westwood?
No.
Not what?
It was a couple months ago about More Life, and Drake talked about because Kanye wasn't happy with he called out Drake and stuff like on his when he having his
rants, yeah.
Right on tour, and Drake commented on this on this interview how he's like confused how like Kanye, you know, says one thing, does another, blah blah blah. So I didn't think I was gonna see a Kanye feature on here.
Yeah,
I had no fucking idea what was on these, and when I heard the Kanye feature, I was very surprised. And Kanye fucking came through.
Yeah.
Oh man, it hits
they
me in my
soul. Together. Give
Watch
us an album
out
of that shit.
Me,
They've hinted at that before.
Yeah.
If only. What did that Kanye verse remind you of? It took a back.
Did take it back.
It took it back.
Yeah, no.
He referenced Touch the Sky. He referenced...
That's late registration shit.
Yeah, I was thinking late registration.
There you go.
Yeah. That's Kanye in like his early years kind of like just being like... Just talking about like... I remember doing shows and no one showing up. I remember my car getting towed. I remember working the fries. I remember this shit. Like, I remember what this is like. And it's such a confrontation to how Kanye West is perceived.
Yes.
Because they perceive that he's arrogant and he's a dick and he forgot where he came from.
He's never forgotten
where he came from. And the thing is, like, this is all about the Kanye mythos. And I'm going to rant about fucking Kanye because you know what it is. I'm fucking wearing the shirt. Like, he's doing the shit. Like, everyone, like, to me, this proves to me that he's not arrogant and a dick, and he's living his life to the fullest because he knows at any moment this could be taken from him.
Mm-hmm. He said that.
Like, that's it. That's all it is. Mm-hmm. Like, people think he's crazy and he's out of control. He's just doing it because it's there now.
And he has such extreme expectations and goals for him and his life and his family.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I guess this is how the path that... He understands the actions he must take to achieve what he wants, and you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dope track.
Track 19.
Yeah.
Since Way Back featuring Party Next Door.
Way back.
Fuck.
Oh fuck.
Well, I like a good party feature.
Party and Joe go well.
Yo, you like the one on the last album? What was it? Dun,
dun, dun, dun, that was on Party's album, wasn't it? Ooh, ooh. Yeah.
No, it was you proved her no something. Where you are?
Whoa, hold up. That was the next song. See?
No, that's
Fake Love.
That's Fake Love. Alright.
I think I've heard Fake Love.
Since Way Back featured Party Next Door. We all just kind of zoned out to that, huh?
A little bit.
Yeah.
That's what I kind of like.
That's my problem with the Party Next Door collaborations.
No, I reckon the last one was more upbeat. Like
the only two that I've ever really, I said one at first, but the only two that I've ever really vibed to was Come and See Me. Is it Come Up and See Me or Come and See Me? That's from Party's record.
Probably Come and See Me, I think.
And then Own It.
I've liked most of the tracks they did together.
Yeah.
Okay. I was vibing to that. It was good.
Oh no, he's on that one from If You're Reading This that I like too, isn't he?
Another one you're thinking of.
What's the track?
Preach?
Yeah.
Preach.
Yeah, I like that too.
Okay. Preach?
Yeah.
Preach.
Okay. Preach.
I'm eating my own words now myself.
No, I was just taking time to see if I liked the track, and I kind of like a little bit of switch up the end. I thought
that was like
really smooth. I think it's a good way to sort of get
you and me. Just kind of like,
yeah, I'm kind of zoning out, just trying to get that YouTube live, which is actually popping right now.
How you doing?
So right
this is YouTube live now.
Sorry?
This is YouTube live.
Yeah, YouTube got a new feature, live feature.
Shut up.
It's actually...
See, we at the Dropout, we ain't used to this level of fame. Like, we...
we're still building. We're very young.
We're staying doing this.
Well, the last three tracks of the album right now, Fake Love, which you've heard before.
Have I heard?
You haven't heard Fake Love?
I don't think I have.
Straight up to my face.
I think I
have.
Okay.
I've been trying to keep away from everything Drake.
Track 20, okay. Fake Love.
The single.
Yeah. People showing fake love to me, straight up to my face. I got fake people showing fake love to me, straight up to my face. Straight up to my face.
Must have said that 5 times by now. More tune for your head top.
Yo!
So watch how you speak his name.
Watch how you speak my name, boy.
The last half of this album was super fucking solid.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Definitely. You know, we heard that before.
We're on a home stretch.
We're on a home stretch. Last two tracks, Fake Love, you know.
I'm getting motherfucking jumper.
A jumper?
Okay, oh, okay, nah,
you gotta get up and move, man. You gotta get up and groove, man. There's nothing to
get... That's how you do.
That's real, though. Like, you're like...
Yeah.
You know, it's... I mean, maybe if you this was a bar full of women and stuff, you'd be moving, but because the Caribbean dance hall vibes kind of get you like that.
I mean, that's the part I didn't like about the album.
Yeah, that's true, but you're still going to get up.
Oh, hell yeah, if they move around.
We ain't got none.
You all know and get it.
You guys know any? I don't know. I don't know if they can hear us properly. The Young Fuck...
Thug,
a Young
baby.
Thug feature, track 21.
Well, maybe this is it.
Put on the wrong way.
Fucking hell.
Maybe this is the Thug feature.
Track 21. Ice melts. That one was better.
That one was better. Yeah, that song was pretty lame.
Oh yeah. Eh.
Yeah.
It's pretty average, I'll be honest.
Young Thug for
one of those tracks that came on somewhere else, I'd be like, oh yeah.
I just think, like, with Thugger, like, I always like it when Thugger brings, like, the energy. Like, you just kind of, like, you just bop it, like, it's a club beat.
Exactly, right. I was like, bopping the whole time.
I was like, yeah. But still, shout out to him for trying new stuff. Like, respect. Exactly, you know
what's new about that? What, Drake or Young Thug?
Thug. It's like, it's a lot softer.
Okay. I don't know enough about Thug to
sound like
to Lil
Yachty can hop on that as well.
Hey guys.
We got one more track.
Can I guess what it's called?
Yeah, sure.
Is it called Outro?
Nope. You fucking shit.
That would be, if it was a Meek Mill album, it would be. Last track, Do Not Disturb.
Used to be in Silver City years ago. Used to be in London playing dominoes. I don't wanna have it, Robin never told me about it. Nowadays when we catching up, we just laugh about it. Can't describe what my life is like when she asks about it. Scary whenever I close my eyes, it ain't gotta burden me. That's the reason you can feel the tension and the urgency. Last chance I get to make sure.
Yo, that was a good closer.
That's More Life, Do Not Disturb. That's the whole album, the playlist, aka I should say.
We did it.
We did it, man. That's a long
81 minutes of that shit.
That's a long playlist.
Yeah.
It's a long playlist.
Your playlist should be 20 songs, though, because it is 20 songs. You win. Short songs, Drake.
That's a good closer, though.
Yeah.
Lyrically strong.
I feel like, as an album overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I'm definitely going to go back to it.
Yeah.
I'm definitely, from start to finish, I could probably, you know, skip maybe 3 or 4 tracks, but I'd probably listen to them again just to see why it fits and how it fits.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it does. Everything has its place. He goes through so many different instrumentals, so many different types of flows.
Yeah.
With his singing and his rapping, the features, I feel most of them were on point.
Yeah.
And some of the sampling that he got as well. Like, all of this album, like, it works really well together. And it's definitely a really polished playlist. I dig it.
Yeah.
Most of it. Just got to listen to it again to get more thought into it.
Yeah, it's like, this is a track album.
No, I don't know. I feel it works pretty well.
I think it flows really well.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've definitely considered the track list and this shit.
Because we start off with a bang. We start off with Free Smoke, No Long Talk. Well, how you doing?
And I feel like Do Not Disturb is a real kind of like chill vibe. Not chill vibe, but it's real kind of, it's real final.
Right.
It's kind of like conclusive. How it's for views.
Yeah. Like, it's a good closer.
Yeah, can you just hold that out like that? Can you hold it out? So you get a view of like all of us? Does that work?
Reminds me like when
the issue
tracks
is
like
sound,
like,
people can hear you.
Yeah, like 9 a.m. so. In yeah. Dallas, or like 4 p.m. in Toronto, whatever the fuck it was. It's like one of those tracks where you just spit in flames.
Good news is like all your American fans can hear you because like it is fucking 1 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah.
What?
Out here.
Yeah, today, now.
All right.
Yeah.
In America, it's like...
Yeah, it's way too early
like,
morning.
It's like morning / afternoon, depending on where you are.
Yeah.
Yeah. But overall, where do you think this album fits in his discography right now? What do you think? Where do you think it'll go down? Cause, hello.
What? I'm just. It's in my face, and I just. it's not good. I don't like it.
It's too early to tell. So I feel like that if you read this is too late when it first dropped, people will be like, oh, it won't be said in his discography. But now over time, it's like it will be said in his discography.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I feel like this album.
This will as well.
Yeah, this will.
Yeah.
There's a lot of quality tracks.
I think
here.
He's changing what a discography can be.
Mm.
Great. There's a lot of quality tracks on here. Drake alluded to the fact he's going to drop another an album in 2018 on that
yeah.
last track.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Clear some things up. Had a lot of great features.
A
lot of great
year
tracks.
Off.
Hey?
That's a whole year off.
Mm-hmm.
More than a year.
Well, he's going to be working during that.
Maybe touring.
Well, most of this album would be finished when he released Views, I'm pretty sure. Would you?
Nah.
You reckon?
Nah, some of this is new.
Mm.
Like that J-Lo sample came after
favorite
Views.
Favorite track from the album, favorite feature from the album.
Oh, it's hard to pick.
Passionfruit was my favorite track.
Passionfruit.
I loved a lot of tracks in the album. But to me, Passionfruit was one of, like, not lyrically the best, but in terms of sonically and the way that it just vibed, I feel like it's a track I can get back to a lot.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Teenage Fever.
Yeah.
Lose You or Can't Have Everything? Can't remember which one.
This feature, you'd probably get Yeezy there.
Yeah.
He's up there.
I can't remember any two other ones.
For me, Teenage Fever is the best track.
Right.
Travis Scott's feature was really good.
Yeah, that was a good feature
really
too.
Good feature.
But I got to give it to Ye.
Always.
Yeah, killed that shit.
Yeah.
That's a quality playlist, you know? That's a quality playlist.
This
right?
this definitely rekindled my kind of like love with Drake.
Yeah, because he's like, oh, he's trying new shit. He's getting to shit that I can vibe a lot more. Like,
yeah.
Like, he's trying more, man. Like,
he's trying more.
He's doing some of the same shit he's done, but he's just like polished it in a different way.
Yeah.
And you like
it. Yeah.
And you like
it. Interesting, the Two Birds, One Stone and the 21 Savage track. Sneaking. That's what it's called.
Think about it.
They didn't make it.
Shit. Sneaking was a piece of shit. It wouldn't have fit it on here though.
No, it wouldn't have. It 100% wouldn't have.
It had no elements of the styles he's already
sold. Yeah, I agree.
Offers a lot of variety, this
maybe,
playlist.
Maybe
a lot to digest, a lot
yeah,
to
a
go
lot
back
to.
Digest.
To. It's hard. We're trying to like give something, but it's hard. We need to come back. There's
yeah.
a lot here. There's
yeah.
a lot here.
Oh yeah, I'll be going back to this now that I can finally listen
a
to
a lot
like
of energy.
Listening to Prophet, yeah. Alrighty.
Alright, man. That's Jungle Beats
Jungle.
Featuring Chris Palmer.
Yeah.
Who's part of Baked Goods, aka also an artist himself.
The Dropout.
Shout out The Dropout. We got to link everything up on how you can find them. Thank you for fucking with us. Why is the chat hidden? I want to see their faces. But
it
anyway,
comes back with a connection.
It's all good.
I don't know why you can't do the side view, but like YouTube doesn't isn't compatible.
Yeah, you gotta speak to YouTube. I'll be calling them today to fuck this shit up. Anyway, full video of More Life's gonna be up soon, and then you'll know where exactly why we're here and what we're doing.
Tell me the better audio is going up. This is just like a live video.
They're
like, why is the audio so shit?
Oh, for sure. We're just live.
The audio is going to be on point.
Something extra.
The mic's for something.
Yeah, the mic's are for something. Thank you for your support. More Life full video coming soon. And what else we did? We did that Kendrick joint, huh?
Yeah, we did that Kendrick single, which was fucking dope.
The Heart Part 4.
Heart Part 4.
Ooh, man.
Fucking balls for days.
Since you uploaded Mac Miller vid about 6 months ago, I'm so happy to see you guys. I've been doing so well. I hope you guys find YouTube. Thank you, MOL. Appreciate that.
Yeah, thank you. Shout out Mac Miller as well.
Probably not.
Favorite MC.
Comments. You gotta love it to digest.
Hey, you're probably gonna take all my data. Yeah, gorillas. We gonna get to those.
Yo, we doing gorillas. We doing gorillas.
You can shove those mic up. We're doing that, man. Appreciate that.
Now, let me hold this mic like a fucking idiot. There we go. Yo, yeah, we doing that.
All right.
We'll talk like this.
All right, we done. Finish that joint.
Ooh, ooh.
Thank you.
Oh.